Hello, students. Today we're going to be dissecting a cow eyeball. Again, as always, you want to orient yourself with the structures externally. So appreciate when we're looking at the eyeball, this will be the cow eye facing you. This grayed out area, this is actually the cornea. So in a live animal or human, this would be clear. But because this eye has been separated from its host or its original creature, it is no longer clear and there's edema in there. So this should be clear. This is the cornea. The white part outside the eye is the sclera, and it's covered by this this connective tissue membrane here, the conjunctiva. So this stuff right here is conjunctiva. Externally around the eyeball, we have muscles coming in and fat. So fat to support and cushion the eyeball, but you have your extraocular muscles. And so remember that sclera is very important for attachment of the conjunctiva, which carries blood vessels to these structures, but then also attachment for the extraocular muscles. Additionally, when you're doing your eyeball dissection, you want to flip it over and look at the posterior aspect. And you should feel a little firm structure. This is actually the optic nerve right here leaving the eye. So remember, this is cranial nerve 2, and this is going to be carrying the axons of the ganglion cells that are in the retina to the brain. So remember, these will go to optic chiasm, and some will cross, some will not, and then we'll go to the thalamus and then up to the primary visual cortex for regular vision. So here, again, we've got our eyeball. The white part of the eyeball, which is kind of hard to see because it's covered by this conjunctiva, is called the sclera. This is conjunctiva, and this is the cornea. When you make your incision, your book might tell you to clear away all of this extraocular tissue. I don't tend to do that because this kind of allows my eyeball to sit in a nice firm way and not roll around a lot. And this gives me stability when I'm actually making my incisions. So, for this, it's very important that you pay attention to your blade and the orientation of your blade. You do not want to cut towards yourself. So I will anchor my eyeball, just set it here onto the surface, and I will actually face my blade away and make a slight puncture wound just lateral, just to the outside of the corneal scleral junction. We call this the limbus. That's the cornea, this is the sclera, and I'm gonna make a little stab incision. And again, this is very tough, so you're gonna have to put a little pressure there, and you're gonna move into and go through that sclera. Once I get through the sclera, I'm going to set my blade down because this is a very delicate incision that we're going to make here. And you're gonna extend your incision with your scissors, your utility scissors, if that's what you have, around this junction. Now there's going to be some liquid leaving the eye. Remember, if it's watery liquid, this is aqueous humor, and remember that is in our anterior cavity, and anterior and posterior chamber of the anterior cavity. So here I've made an incision around the cornea, not right at the edge, so that I can maintain those structures. And now I'm going to move the cornea and retract it to the outside. And what you can see here, I maybe should have made my incision a little bit wider, so maybe you should make yours a little wider. But here we see this firm structure here. This is actually the lens. This is very important to appreciate. It's actually quite hard. It should be clear, okay? But again, because this eyeball is not alive, we're not seeing that. Additionally, you're going to see this jelly-like substance that is posterior to the lens. So remember, anything that's behind the lens is our posterior cavity, and this jelly-like substance is called vitreous. Now, the job of the vitreous is a couple of things. One, it is clear and it does refract light, but mostly it is formed and like has substance so that it can keep the retina attached to the back of the eye. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to attempt to remove this vitreous gently, and you may actually want to use the back of your brown adsense here, and you can just kind of scoop it out very gently. You want to be very gentle moving this. Sometimes it comes out all at once, and that's always lovely when that happens, but that's not the case today. So we're going to just gently scoop this vitreous out. So again, the function of the vitreous is to hold the retina in place. So you can appreciate if I'm removing the vitreous, there's a very good chance my retina could come with it. So we want to try to avoid that if possible, but that doesn't always happen. So here you can see I've removed the vitreous. There is a little bit of fluid in there. And this tan structure back here, that is actually my retina. We're going to come back to that in just a minute. So again, anything in front of the lens is called the anterior cavity. Anything posterior to the lens is called the posterior cavity. Now, I'm going to actually remove the lens here. And when I remove it, if we can zoom in very up close here, you're going to see little fibers tearing as I remove this lens. And these fibers are attached to this muscle right here. This is my ciliary muscle, this is my lens, and these are the zonial fibers. So I'm actually going to tear these. Do you see those tearing? As I remove the lens here. So remember, those are what hold the lens in place. And as this ciliary muscle changes shape, either contracts or relaxes, it's going to change the shape of the lens. And this is going to allow us to focus up close or far away. So we're looking through the eye like the cow would be looking. This space right here, this open space, is actually called the pupil. This right here is the iris, this thin muscle here. And remember, it's actually two muscles. And then we have our ciliary muscle, which is part of the ciliary apparatus, which is right here. And remember, those little fibers were holding that lens in place. This space in front of the iris is called the anterior chamber of the anterior cavity. The space that is posterior to the iris but anterior to the lens is called the posterior chamber of the anterior cavity. So it's important to appreciate that in this anterior cavity, we have a different type of fluid. We have a watery fluid, this stuff right here. It's called aqueous humor. And then in the posterior cavity, we had this jelly-like fluid. Also important to appreciate, if we take this eye and kind of look from the outside, we have different layers of the eye. So this outer layer, not the tan stuff, but the white part of the eye, the sclera, and the cornea are called the fibrous tunic. As we go in towards the center of the eye, we have our choroid. And the choroid is made up of the ciliary muscle, the iris, and this darkened area here that is called the choroid. So we have our vascular tunic, which is ciliary muscle, iris, and choroid here. Okay, and this choroid is going to be housing all the vessels, or a lot of the vessels that supply the eye. Okay, and remember, inside of that we have the retina. Okay, so now we're going to remove the retina here. So first of all, when you're looking at this retina, it doesn't look like too much. It's tan, it's just kind of bland. Remember, that is three layers of cells. We have the most outermost layer of cells, which are your photoreceptors. Then towards the middle, we have our bipolar cells, and then we have the ganglion cells. And pretty much the axons of all the ganglion cells there are going to be leaving the eye at the optic disc right here. So you can see everything kind of coming together right there. That's going to be my optic disc. Let me see if I can just remove that fluid just a little bit. So you can see that right there. So as you come in here, you can see the retina is kind of separated here, but I'm gonna remove that retina or lift it over to the side. We still have a little vitreous there. And behind that, what do you see? We see a very refractive, very colorful structure here. This is part of the choroid. So remember, from inner to out, we have retina, choroid, sclera. And the choroid, again, has pigment. And in this area, it's this shiny blue, green, yellow area. This is what we call the topedum lucenum. And the topedum lucenum is not in humans. We do not have that. But this is an area that is highly refractive and allows a lot of animals to see at night. There's only a few animals that do not have this, or a few mammals that do not have this. Most do. This is why when you shine a light into your eyes, or we take a flash photography, we get red eye. We do not have this, and so we actually can see the vessels of the choroid very well. And those are what reflect back. When you take a picture of your cat or your dog and you get the picture back and it's got like a green or yellow glow, you are seeing the Topedum Lucenum. And that's helping refract light and improve vision at night. Okay, so just to orient, again, we have our retina, which is this inner layer. We have the choroid, which is this dark pigmented layer. And again, our vessels are there, and I'm gonna attempt to separate that away from the sclera. And remember the sclera, let's see if I can get that separated. The sclera is the tough white outer layer. So this sclera right here, that's our tough outer layer. So again, I'm lifting up the choroid there. This is the retina, this tan stuff. Where the retina leaves the eye is called the optic disc. And of course, it's gonna leave, those axons leave as the optic nerve.